Okay, the test results are in. Today we'll be looking at an oil analysis from a 2016 GMC Yukon that used OW20 Supertech synthetic oil and a Supertech oil filter, number MP10575. And a viewer named Clyde sent this report in to me. So let's get started.
This is a network. You got a really good silicone, nice and tight. Get your inner ear, filtration.
Okay, so first off, I want to thank Clyde for sending me in this report. Thanks, Clyde. And right here they have their comments. You can pause this video if you want and read this, but basically it's just saying the TBN was at 3.4. Try 7,000 miles next time and good first report. So if we look down here, he went 5,191 miles on this oil and he has 79,126 miles on his truck and the sample date. Okay, so we'll look at the first one, aluminum 3. Your universal average is 4. 3 is not really worth mentioning, but that could come from piston skirts, stuff like that. Chromium is 1. That ain't worth, the universal is 1. That ain't worth mentioning. Iron is 8. You have iron all throughout your engine, so that could come from anywhere. But universal is 23, so that's a good number. Copper 17. Universal is 36, 17 is a good number. That could come from bearings, bushings. And you got lead 10, 0, 0. Molybdenum 75. Universal is 107. Nickel 0, manganese 1, not worth mentioning. Silver 0, titanium 0, potassium 1. Universal is 3, not worth mentioning. Boron 94, universal is 51. And the boron is a detergent additive. Silicone is 12, the universal is 17. So that's not too bad. That could be dirt. Also, sometimes it comes could come from silicone sealants. There's usually some already in the oil, so that's not a big number. There's no problem there. Sodium 6, universal is 15. Sodium can be found in some oils. It's a corrosion inhibitor additive, but it's not used in this one. Sometimes it could be antifreeze too if you got a high number there. So 6 is pretty good though. Calcium 1262, universal is 1299. Let me lower this down. Okay, and 1299 was universal for calcium, 1262. And calcium is a detergent additive, so it's good to have a high amount of that. Magnesium 569, universal 561, and that helps keeps oil in suspension. Phosphorus 726, universal average 663, and phosphorus is another anti-wear additive. Zinc 814, universal 759, and zinc is also another, it also acts as another anti-wear additive. Okay, and that's for the additives and the metals. Okay, let's go to viscosities. 210 Fahrenheit, 50.6, which is in spec. It's between the 46 to 57. 100 Celsius, 7.44, which is between the 60 and 9.7, so that's all in spec. Flash point is 370, which is kind of low. It starts off at 420. So it's a little bit low, and I'll see right down here, you can see why, because it's got a little bit of fuel in it. 0.8, which isn't a lot of fuel, but it's got some in it. And insolubles 0.2. So the filter is doing a pretty good job. And a TBN 3.4, which you don't want to go below 1. And the TBN on this oil starts off at 7.1. I have a virgin oil analysis of this oil, which I'm going to show in a minute. Yeah, this report looks pretty good. It's got some wear metals, but not that much. I myself probably wouldn't go much past 5,000 miles either, seeing that there's some fuel in there. And let's look at this report side by side with a virgin oil analysis. So I'll set this camera up here. I get this set up. This virgin sample of oil wasn't taken from the same bottle of oil, so it's not going to be exact. I mean, it'd be a lot better if you had a same bottle comparison. But, you know, this was posted online. I found it, and I just figured it, be fun just to see how the numbers match up. So the molybdenum, you got 71 here. Clyde's was 75. Boron was 221 and 94. So it seems like some of it got used up. Silicone was 12. Over here it's 6. Sodium was 4. Over here it's 6. Calcium is pretty close. 1214. 1262. Magnesium's pretty close. 546. 569. Phosphorus is, they're all close here. 706 to 726. And the zinc, 786 to 814. And let's go down here to viscosities. And here you can see the oil got either sheared or diluted from the fuel. So it started off as 53.5. It's 50.6. Which, you know, these are small numbers, so it's not bad. 8.33 went to 744. And of course, they got 0, 0, 0. They're all zeros there because there's nothing in it. I forgot to mention the difference in flash points. As you can see, the virgin oil sample has a higher flash point than the used oil sample. And the TBN starts at 7.1 and it ended up at 3.4. So overall, I'd say this is a good report, and I want to thank Clyde for sending this in to me. And this is the oil filter that Clyde was using. And I'm going to do a video on this oil filter this coming Friday. So we'll see what it looks like. So I think I'll wrap this video up. Hey, if you like this video, please hit that thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and take care.